Good morning, everyone. My name is Sean Iskhandar. I'm from Motivate Projects Private Limited. We are a company based in Singapore and Malaysia. So we provide AV systems consultancy for venues, from stadiums to even clubs and theaters and performing arts venues. Okay, today I have with me my ex-colleague from Sennheiser, right, Mr. Herman Suparman. He is currently now working for Herman Professional. Okay, and today we'll be speaking on elevating the sound experience for stadiums. I'd like to thank again for you to attend this seminar or this industry talk. Thank you again. Again, we can start. Okay. So, as you can see here, we have actually the Bukit Jalil Stadium in the background. And I work together with Herman to supply this sound system that was in 2017 before the SEA Games. And it was actually used for the SEA Games opening and closing ceremony. Okay, so why are we talking about stadiums at a football summit? Okay, stadiums or sound itself, it's part of the stadium that provides the sound experience. That's provide the AV experience. So when you go to a stadium, first thing you want to listen and hear the announcement that's being made or about who scored. And visually you want to see replays and you see the scores, right? So it's all under what we call match day entertainment. And if you look at the match day and gate revenues by the English Premier League clubs, from Arsenal to Leicester, so this brings in a lot of revenue for the club itself. All right, it's compared to, I would say, what's happening in Asia, because most of the stadiums that's being used by football clubs are owned by the state or owned by the government, right? But in Europe, the football stadiums are being owned by the clubs and they are revenue generators. As you can see, let's look at Manchester United. In 2016-2017, the match day revenues earned them £112 million. This is through gate receipts, F&B, hospitality suites and retail. Okay, so it's something that for us to think about, how we can try to emulate and help our clubs can generate revenue through the stadiums via maybe F&B or hospitality suites and retail, you know, aside from gate receipts. Okay. So demands for higher sound quality in stadia. We're looking at three points that you need to know, which is intelligibility, loudness, and bandwidth. Okay, intelligibility is explained in clarity in speech transmission. That means you as the audience, you can hear what is being announced or said over the sound system. And it can be measured through the STI or speech transmission index. You look at loudness, which is measured in SPL, sound pressure level. The technical term is DBA. So this is just how loud can the sound go. It's volume. And when we talk about bandwidth, which is the frequency range, which in audio, the frequency range is from 20 hertz to 20 kilohertz. So when you talk about sound, it's these three things. Okay? And I will have that theme going through my presentations. Okay, so what else are we looking at in the stadium sound? Right? You, the audience, expect an audio experience like going to a concert or listening to your headphones or a home theater system. So you want the sound to be heard clearly and announcements clearly is because you're just watching like a movie at home. Okay, so looking at sound systems that is being installed in stadiums for the past 20 years or 30 years, it is a PA system, right? So a PA system is only for speech transmission to convey messages or for public evacuation. So safety is actually one of the main criteria to install a sound system, where if there's something happens in the stadium, right, announcements can be made and they can evacuate all the spectators properly and not have a stampede. So that's why a PA system is installed in stadiums. And it's no longer acceptable because, you know, stadium owners or audience expect more. And a PA system is quite limited in their frequency range and SPL. Okay? And nowadays, venues or football teams, they want to have some musical content or performances. So we want a higher, you need to have a higher powered sound system rather than a PA. And as well as the football clubs, if they have sponsors, they want to do activations through video, and they have advertisements with audio clip as well. So the sponsors would definitely want the audience to hear. So we look at all these things, and that's why we are looking at advising or consulting stadiums to install more than a PA system. Okay, so for PA systems or sound systems, FIFA has technical recommendations. Okay, in the technical and recommendation guidebook, FIFA edition 2011, this is the latest one. And they tells you what or how the sound system must perform. And we look at the three criteria again, which is an STI of 0.55, okay, a minimum SPL of 105 dBA, and a frequency range that can produce sound from 120 Hz to 5 kHz. Okay, quite modest, right? So we look at UEFA tournament requirements. Okay, here, they are not asking you to have a PA system. They're asking you to have, or you must have, a sound entertainment system. So that's the difference, yeah? So a PA system is just for public announcements or voice evacuations, but a sound entertainment system is what you need to produce higher SPL musical content. Okay, and they even have a model where they want the sound to travel. Man, you must have provisions that you can avoid hitting sound at the center, which is the media, right? So this is very detailed modeling and requirements by UEFA. And this is for the Euro 2020. And they're asking for an STI of 0.7, which is quite high, and 110 dBA, and a frequency range of 160 Hz to 12 kHz. Okay, so with that understanding, we will design a system based on international requirements that's been set by FIFA and also UEFA, right? But these are, I would say, UEFA is more on Europe side where they have massive crowds for their games. And tournament requirements for Euro is when a lot of people will be filling up the stadiums and the audience will get loud. So you need to have a system that can produce louder levels than the spectators. Okay, so as you can see here, these are sound systems that's been installed in the past for the purpose of PA. The left side is in a stadium in Malaysia. And here, Roop Arena is, I believe, in the USA or UK. You can see it's like a flower. Okay. So we're looking at the sound reinforcement system in Bukit Jalil, which we both worked on. Okay. You can see that the light is pointing to the speaker. Coincidentally, I took this picture during the opening ceremony of the SEA Games in 2017. Okay. And this is how now modern sound systems looks like. It's a line array with multiple speakers covering different areas of the venue. And the brand that was installed in Bukit Jalil Stadium is L Acoustics. And previously we were at Sennheiser Asia, who were the distributors for L Acoustics. And we were working on the project, I think, for about 2 years, and executed it and delivered in 2017. Okay. So what type of speakers do we have, or what's the quantity of speakers that we have? So we have 108 Kara systems, 16 Kara systems for the peel of play, 256 Kiva 2 for the outer ring, 136 Fire ST field speakers, and 77 amplifiers. All right, so where are they being installed at? Okay, so you can see that the inner ring, okay, the first ring in front, and the outer ring is at the back, with the 5 XTs installed in the under balconies, okay? And, you know, for sound now, we can simulate the performance for sound, okay? So technology has come so far that you can predict sound. So here we can have a design for the sound systems. You can see there on the top, which is the Kara system, and below is the Kiva 2s. And you can see on the right side, there are certain lines that goes down, which is to point the directivity or the coverage for the sound. So in modern sound system design, there is already software that can predict the sound so that you can already know their performance. Okay, and here we look at the performance of coverage and SPL. So as you can see, the top picture on the yellow and the green there. So the yellow part is where the sound is hitting, right? And you can see that the yellow, you'll be around 105 dB. That's the SPL. And here we have another software that you can see that it states that direct SPL mapping. So you can already know the SPL or the volume that you can achieve through software. Okay, and a few photos with my handsome colleague here on the ground. You know, we are checking on the speaker angles to make sure that it's correct. And there's, we also have a laser, right, Herman? Laser as well. And we have test measurement mics to measure the actual performance of the sound. Okay? And here we are again. So this is during the sound tuning process where we actually take actual measurements of the sound. And you can see the at the bottom here, that's where the amplifiers are installed, okay? And I have some videos of the Bukit Jalil Stadium, so we can take a listen. So I took this video recordings on a handphone, on an iPhone, so you can see the sound quality there. Pardon the video. Just listen to the sound. Can you make it a little bit louder? So that clip is a song by London Grammar. Maybe perhaps our friends from UK will know, right? So you can hear that the stadium itself has the natural ambience or reverb that, you know, is quite nice sound, I would say to it. Okay. This is during the opening ceremony for the SEA Games. Thank you. so everyone enjoyed the performance. And this was taken, I was on the uppermost balcony, and we were receiving sound from the top speakers there, which is the Kiva 2s. So the song was in Malay, but you can see and you can hear that the vocal is quite clear, and the audience were quite receptive, hearing the song and cheering. So hence, that's why we always advocate, you know, to have a sound system or louder sound system that can be louder than the crowd and engage the crowd and excite the crowd. Okay. And it was also used for the SEA Games, okay? And the upper balconies is being served by the speakers that's installed. They do have sound systems on the ground, right? But this only shoots to up to the second tier seats, right? And because there's weight loading issues and they can't fly bigger sound systems on the stadiums. Hence, you know, we use the install system, which can give the performance and produce the sound level that they require for an opening sporting event. All right, next we'll go to the Mercedes-Benz Stadium. So this also was completed, I believe, in 2018, right? And it's one of the new stadiums in the USA, which is in Atlanta, and they have introduced a lot of new technologies here. It's installed with a sound system from the States called Danley Sound Labs. And their unique proposition is, or they're famous for their Synergy horn, which has all the drivers installed in one speaker. And it looks like this. So you have the low frequency driver and high frequency driver and mid frequency drivers all in one box. Okay. It's not a line array, it's a point source, so that's just one box, you know, producing the frequency range that they require. And they are installed in 5 of the biggest stadiums in the USA. These are football stadiums, and football stadiums are quite massive. They range from maybe about size of 50,000 packs to 100,000 capacity. So college stadiums are quite big in the States. And here you can see one of the stadiums is an open stadium, and there's no avenues for you to hang speakers. So maybe perhaps a solution like a point source, a big box, is better for this type of venues. Okay, as you can see here, on the left side, there's a line array solution, and then the Danley systems is just two box for the highs and another two box for the lows. You can see that. So that's a line array. They have like 16 boxes there compared to the Danley sound system, which is two boxes. But these boxes are not small boxes, right? So it's as huge as, in terms of height, as 4 of the line array speakers. Okay, so these are two solutions that we'll look at for this project. As you can see there, so comparing low frequency speakers with the Danley speakers, which is 3 meters, the line array is about 8.5 meters. Okay, and again, you have sound prediction software where you can see simulate the or measure the level that is being produced before you. You know, install the system so you can see the performance here. And because the States, they emphasize a lot of low frequency, they want the boom boom in sound to, you know, like if you go to a club, you have the bass frequency, or even on the main stage, you have the bass frequencies that provide the low and boom. Okay, so they want that in the stadium, hence. And this frequency is around maybe 50 hertz to 80 hertz. So here the measurement or simulation for 80 hertz by the Danley sound system, you achieve quite a good result. As you can see there, it's in red. And you can measure the sound. For the line array system, they propose 120 cabinets, which costs a lot, but they only achieve about 0.39 STI. Okay? So the maximum STI or the better performance is on maybe a value nearest to one. Acceptable value for sporting venues is 0.55. So this could not achieve a 5, a 0.5 STI, so it wasn't a good result. And Danley's solution, with just 16 Danley Jericho horns and 4 Synergy horns and 8 subs, could meet a STI of 0.5, and it also costs lesser. So it's quite a cost-effective solution, but not to reduce in performance. And here you can measure STI. So how you measure is with a microphone, and you have a software that can take in the sound and provide you the measurement. Okay. So here, measurement was taken at different points of the stadium. As you can see, there's a few values. There's 0.5, 0.49, 0.6. So the software will give you an average STI value, which then limit at 0.5. Okay. Here, as you can see sound. Through this software, you can see that the frequency range or the level of the sound is quite linear. And because they want a low frequency energy as well, as you can see, with the subwoofers, you have an increase in volume on the low frequency, that's from 30 hertz to 60 hertz. Okay. So this is how the Danley speakers actually look like over in Mercedes-Benz Arena. So you have the tops on the left side of the screen and the sounds, the low frequency subwoofer on the right side. Okay, can anybody spot the speakers? No? Right? It's actually over there. So in terms of sight lines, it's not disturbing the view for the LEDs, which is quite important. Okay? Right, so I'm going to pass to my friend here, and he's going to be talking a little bit on Herman and also the solution that they provided for the Tottenham Hotspur Stadium that was just recently opened.
Hi, good morning. Assalamualaikum. So my name is Herman from Herman Professionals, based in Singapore. We're covering APAC region. So Herman is a big company, which been bought over by Samsung. So we are now collaborating together with Samsung's LED for the professional side. So in Herman, our portfolio covers from cars, lifestyle, and professional solutions. Okay? We do audio, lighting, and video controls. So some of the projects that we cover vertically will be theme parks, stadiums, convention hall, transportation areas, and also museums. We are professionally inclined with house of worships, sports areas, arenas, cruise ships, and so on. So what is important for our end user? So you have light, sound, video control. Technically, most of it has individually controlled by an operators. So what Herman does is we have our own system solution that we make all these light, sound, video control communicate to each other via our protocol. This is some projects in stadiums that we have done in the world. If you can see top on side of the LED side, there will be our VLA compact. So for Tottenham Stadiums, what Herman does, we actually install our VLA compact. It's IP rated, so technically it's good for our weather in Asia, humidity. And then we also have a digital console. It's a linearity system that acts as a point source or array as what you want, accordingly to the design. So we can actually adjust the clarity of the speakers towards point source or also linearity systems. And this is the subs that we are using it. And we also have the AWC, which is our all-weather control system. So all these speakers are being placed around the stadium exteriorly. And the Control 25 is being planted along the corridors inside the stadium itself, like say back of house and so on, changing room and all that areas. And we use soundcraft mixers to operate and send signal throughout the whole speakers in the arena itself. Thank you.
All right. So if there's any questions from the floor, do we have a mic that the audience can talk into? We want to be here. I think for AV itself is quite an important component for the football business or for stadiums, and football clubs have I would say in the region have not capitalized on the usage of the stadiums, and because they are government owned. But I see that I think it's a conversation that we need to strike up between the football clubs that uses the stadium for the games, and also the stakeholders for the stadium, and I think there's more that it can be made to monetize the venue through avenues of hospitality, retail, spaces for events, and even seminar rooms, or even a room size like this. And there's a few stadiums that has already gone into providing additional facilities where they can rent out during non-match games, where it provides an interesting value proposition because of the location of the stadium, the venue, and if it has an anchor tenant, so you can, you know, you are playing or you're having an event over at a Hotspur Stadium or even Amsterdam Arena, and with all the marketing or the branding of the club that is the anchor tenant over at that stadium, so you have a different experience, right? And the trend is now is to provide elevated experience for all the senses, visually, audio, F&B, and it's more. It has become like a lifestyle destination for stadiums, and I think that's the way to go. Even the Sports Hub in Singapore is an integrated lifestyle destination. It's not marketed as a stadium; it's a lifestyle destination. So, it's utilizing the venue further, not only for sports, but as well as for commercial activities, because I think revenue generation is important for national stadiums. Like in Singapore, you know, we don't have anchor tenants like the European stadiums, which are owned by the clubs. And for instance, some of the stadiums in specific, for example, in Bayern Munich, which is the Allianz Arena, their events is more or brings in more revenue than the football activities, right? The football games is like about now, I would say about 10%, and the rest is coming from outside events. So during, I would say, winter or is it summer? Winter. The venue is being rented for other activities, and during the season of the games, right, it's being used for football. But after that, it's being used for concerts, events, and all of other things. So you got to be creative with how you want to monetize your stadium venues, and football clubs should perhaps work together with the venue operators to have a win-win situation where there's more revenue for the stadium side and more revenue for the football club side. So that's the conversation that we want to strike up in this summit in Malaysia and also in Singapore. And another example where in Singapore they did the Tampines Hub, right, which is one of the districts in Singapore. They have integrated the stadium with even a library, a theatre, a food center, And what else, Herman? This is at your... You live in Tampines?
Cinemas, performing venues.
Right, right.
Basketball courts.
Swimming pool?
Swimming pools, yeah. Concert areas.
So it's become like a destination for the community. And it really goes back to the community itself to support the football club and football, support the stadium. But it has to be, you know, more than a football stadium. It has to be a lifestyle destination hub for the community. All right. I think with that, we can end our session. If you have any questions or you have any projects that you want to talk to us about, feel free. We'll be around. Thank you so much for attending this talk. And enjoy the rest of the day and the football summit. Thank you very much.
Thank you.